Hello, Internet, and welcome to my live reaction for The Cuckoo's Fiancé, or A Couple of Cuckoos, Chapter 132. When we last left our heroes, Nagi interrupted Ryuto's proposal, causing Erika to denounce him as a scumbag, and forcing Nagi and Ryuto to have a tense conversation, including a punch to the face, where Nagi realizes just what he wants and the sort of, you know, acknowledgement that he's in the wrong here, especially because he has a girlfriend. But also the fact that he doesn't, you know, that he does genuinely like Erika, and he has to, we've reached a point where he needs to deal with that, and so he acknowledges that, and he goes to Erika to apologize to find that she has vanished from their hotel room with a whole, like, line of, like, Mokuba-style bedsheets leading down to the ground from their balcony. She's somewhere out in the world. We don't really know where. So with that said, let's dive right on into the 132nd foul. Won't you listen to your girlfriend? I'm assuming we're going to have a phone call with Hiro over the course of this chapter. I don't know what that will end up looking like because, given what's going on in Nagi's head, I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see. Anyway, I think this is I. Not quite sure, because the hair is a little different, but, like, that seems to be who this is, and another sort of fancy dress. I know 131 had a fancy Sachi picture. Did the previous two chapters also do that sort of thing? I don't quite remember. 130 didn't even have, I think 130 and 129 both didn't really have cover pages, so I think that's I, but I can't, like, see a trend of this that goes beyond last chapter to really tell. Anyway, after hearing Nagi's true feelings, Erika goes missing from the hotel. Where could she have gone? And we pick up in the middle of a storm. Like, waves, you know, dashing against the coast. Like, the palm trees blowing in the wind. A trash can upended by the wind that slams right next to Erika, who is caught in the storm. That was close. Ah, this sucks. I wasn't expecting this. And since I left in such a hurry, I forgot to bring anything. What should I do? So yeah, she's sort of in a bad spot right here. And then we cut to, like, chattering inside the hotel, as they're all sort of stuck here by this storm. As the patrons all ask, you know, when we can go back? Aren't there any alternative forms of transport? How is the situation at the airport? The hotel worker tries to calm them all down. We are offering to provide for your food, so until the storm passes, please feel free to stay at the hotel. Because it's dangerous, please refrain from going outside. And Nagi, apparently the storm happened quick enough that, like, Nagi did not have a chance to leave. He's just, you know, it was bright sunny, and now, in the time it took him to go track down Erika, the storm picked up. Or no, maybe he went outside already, because we see he's drenched. He's, like, has this towel. And yeah, he's definitely been outside. You can see, like, the way his shirt is, like, clinging to him is very much like the way a wet shirt acts. And Ryuto approaches him. No good on my end, either. She's nowhere inside the hotel. Nagi comments, not around outside, either. Which, you know, would be why he's soaking wet. And since she's left her phone behind, there's nothing else we can do. And Nagi just frets, where did you go, Amino-san? And Ryuto tells him, I think it's best that we alert the police. I'll go tell the manager. Nagi just sits there, definitely feeling a little guilty, given the sense that it was his words that sort of drove Erika to this. Please don't tell me it'll end up like this. He has this, like, he has, you know, a typical, like, Nagi worst-case scenario fantasy. Like, helicopters all over the island. The search effort continues in full force. And, like, missing bulletins for Erika. Please. And someone questions, Umino-kun? And Hiro's here. Okay. That's not gonna make this arc any more that's not gonna make this arc any less emotionally conflicting. Okay. Which shocks Nagi, of course, and me. Seigo-san, my guess is, I think Sachi knew where they were. And, you know, Hiro was wondering where they had gone off to, why Nagi wasn't answering her texts. And so I think she got the info from Sachi. I think that's happened in the past before. And Hiro just notes, there you are. And Nagi just sputters, huh? Why? Why? Well, that's because, and she like storms up to Nagi who questions, huh? Is she mad? Well, I mean, she'd be madder if she knew everything you had done. And she like pouts at him. I couldn't get a hold of you this entire time. And when I asked Dashi-chan, she said she heard that you and Erika-chan went to Okinawa. Thank goodness I somehow made it here before the storm. And Nagi is just sort of confused. Sorry, I've just been so busy this whole time. And actually, I haven't gotten any messages from you. And he looks down and realizes with like a start, I put my phone on airplane mode on the flight over. And Hiro just lays into him. Jeez, here I thought something happened to you. I was worried, you know. And it's not like I could have asked Erika-chan about it either. And we see here, Hiro still dealing with all of that sort of awkwardness that's been going on since Nagi and Erika became, like, official. The whole, you know, you can't exactly ask the girl who also likes your boyfriend where your boyfriend is. That's an uncomfortable conversation. And Nagi doesn't really comment on that. I'm sorry. But Hiro picks up. So anyway, what are you doing soaking wet like that? And we cut to a wave crashing into the shore, shocking Erika. Presumably Nagi is telling Hiro everything. And she just reacts, what was that? These waves are crazy. Holy. And after that moment of, like, excitement, the isolation of her situation sits in. And she crouches on the ground under this shed she's found. Where am I even? If only I could somehow find my way back to the hotel. And we see, like, this Okinawa real estate sign, like, rattling in the wind. Which, my initial assumption seeing that sign was that, like, it would give her, like, a solution that she could, like, go to there. Maybe, like a real estate office? I don't know. But no, she just mutters in like, despair. What do I do? And back at the hotel, Hiro has learned everything. What do you mean you can't reach her? She left without her phone. What about the people at the hotel? They're too busy handling all the guests right now. And Hiro sort of, like, directs Nagi. Just in case, I think it's best we contact her family. Yeah. And think Segawa-san sure is dependable. Right now, a childhood friend of... This is Nagi talking to Hiro. Right now, a childhood friend of hers should be contacting the police for us. It looks like the weather's only going to get worse from here. And we see there's an alert for a flood and landslide warning. Which is a bad time to be out in outside. And with that, he comes to, like, a realization. He, like, suddenly turns and runs off. I'm gonna head out and look again. Just stay here and wait for now. And then he freezes. As Hiro tells him, don't go. It's dangerous for you too. Can't we just let the police handle it? So here, it looks like Hiro won't necessarily need to find out about the proposal disruption for her to have a rough conversation about Nagi's priorities. Because right now, in the midst of the storm and Hiro's, like, best friend going missing, she doesn't really want her boyfriend to run off. But Nagi's priority is not her right now. Anyway, can we just let the police handle it? Won't you listen to your girlfriend? She, like, here's our money shot, as she, like, we get this full shot of her imploring this to Nagi. And Nagi looks at Hiro and sees her distress. And he pauses for a moment before saying, And Hiro plays it off, which is not the healthiest choice here, Hiro. I see what you're doing, but this is not a super healthy move. Just kidding. And she, like, you know, pulls her own, like, face up for the smile, which only signifies how fake it all is. I'll help look, too. You go that way. We can split up and search. All right. If anything happens, get in touch immediately. Roger. And they, this time with, like, actual raincoats, they leave the hotel to try to find Erika. And we cut to Nagi, who I'm assuming is going to be the one to find her. But, like, out of breath in the storm. It's no good. She's nowhere to be found. And then he has a sudden thought. Maybe if it's Amino-san, then... And we see, you know, Erika's sandals. As someone calls out, there you are! At last! And here's a big old money shot. As Erika mutters, Nagi-kun? But it's not Nagi. It's Hiro. Though, you know, the sign is very clear there that that's not necessarily who Erika wanted to rescue her. And, like, I don't think she ever would have guessed Hiro, but I think the fact that she says Nagi over, say, Rihito sort of shows her own priorities in this moment. Though also, in typical Yoshikawa fashion, this is an absolutely gorgeous two-page spread. Like, this is the real money shot. Yeah, it's the art in this series is always fantastic, and here we are again. And then we cut to Hiro calling Nagi. I've got Erika-chan safe and sound. Nagi's back at the hotel, drying off with Rihito. That's great. Where are you now? And Hiro doesn't really answer that, just responding, what about you? Nagi responds, the hotel. Thought that maybe she might have come back. Well, you couldn't be more wrong. Anyway, everything's fine. We're taking a break in a safe place. Yeah, we don't hear that part of the conversation, as Erika just looks sad at all of this. That you couldn't be more wrong is an interesting line to me. I'm not quite sure, like, it doesn't seem like it's the thing you would say if Nagi just guessed wrong, but that, like, where Erika was like the opposite of the hotel. I don't know, I'm not sure where they are. But yeah, they're just in some building. Like, I mean, the name of the building is in Japanese, but, like, I don't think we're meant to know what this building is. Let's stay here until the storm passes, okay? Yeah. And Hiro's acting all casual here. Okinawa, huh? It's my first time here, but this typhoon sure is something, don't you think? And Erika just mutters, yeah. And they sit there. I imagine Nagi's proposal interruption sitting heavy in Erika's mind, along with, like, everything else that's going on. And if they sit there in silence, Hiro finally speaks. I thought this might be a good opportunity. Let's have a little chat about Umino-kun. And Erika agrees, I've been thinking we need to talk too. Finally, face to face. Next time, just what are they going to talk about? I mean, I imagine is the very particular dynamic they're all in, with, you know, Nagi's very blatant crush on Erika and the fact that he's dating Hiro. That's not a question, is my point to the blurb. We know what they're talking about. But yeah, this chapter, like, I'll say the typhoon is a little contrived. It's a little, like, it would have been one thing if, like, we had heard, you know, a kind of, like, background report about bad weather coming, or if there had been, like, a cloudy sky in the previous chapter. Like, when I look back at on page 20 of 131, we see, like, a heavy wind as Nagi tells Rihito he's going to apologize to Erika, which I suppose is some degree of foreshadowing. That's really all we get. Like, it's there, but, like, I don't know. I think looking back, that actually does do the job. There is a little bit of a sign, like, this storm is coming. It's not, like, completely out of the blue. But yeah. I don't, you know, I was not expecting a storm like this. And I don't know. I lost my train of thought there. Where am I thinking? What are my thoughts? I don't know. Like, you could also argue if you wanted to be very, like, you know, based in reality or based in real world logic, that, like, Hiro showing up is a bit of a contrivance, but also it ramps up the drama of this arc, from a character, like, stakes standpoint, even more than the typhoon does. It's like, oh, you know, right as Nagi is having all these feelings about maybe Erika is the girl he wants to be with, you know, here comes his girlfriend trying to save the girl he maybe actually wants to be with. And, like, you know, it's, that won't, you know, don't go, let the police handle this conversation with Hiro and Nagi is such, like, peak Yoshikawa, with, like, these characters scratching at these, like, very, you know, intense emotions that they have about their romantic, especially their romantic feelings, but also this, you know, ups up. It ups that ups the stakes there with the typhoon. And so Hiro, who maybe doesn't really want Nagi to go after Erika, has no choice but to laugh it off. You know, she feels like, oh, can't you stay with me? But also, that is, like, several bridges too far when Erika is in actual danger. It's a very sort of, you know, complex Yoshikawa fraught romantic conversation that, like, this series has always really excelled in, as I always say. But yeah, it looks like the next chapter, that next conversation, is going to be big. I don't know. I'm excited to see what comes of that. Because again, if like I've sort of been saying for weeks now, if the result of this conversation is Nagi, you know, the Nagi clearly has feelings for Erika more than he does for Hiro, and so why don't they just date? That's the fuse that sets the whole series up to end. Because if the common assumption that I am very much a fan of, that Nagi Eri is endgame, then, like, we're nearing that point. And, of course, it's a harem manga that can maybe find some way to drag it out, of course. But, like, it really is kind of feeling like this is building up towards an ending. I don't know. I'm just excited to see where Yoshikawa takes all this next. Because it's some really, really well-constructed drama here. And I love it. I'm a fan of this series. In case you haven't worked that out yet, I really do love this series and the way Yoshikawa constructs these dramas. Anyway, that being said, I'm going to leave this video off here. Hope you'll enjoy the chapter and the video itself. If you did, feel free to drop me a like or subscribe or, you know, do whatever makes it happy, you know? And as always, your life is your own, okay? Bye!